हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, तो इन द टुडेस क्लास लेट अस डिस्कस अबाउट द एप्लीकेशंस ऑफ डिटरमिनेंट्स एंड मैट्रिसेस। तो व्हाट एग्जैक्टली द एप्लीकेशंस, तो वी विल यूज दिस मैट्रिक्स एंड डिटरमिनेंट कॉन्सेप्ट टू सॉल्व द सिस्टम ऑफ इक्वेशंस इन अ टू वेरिएबल एंड थ्री वेरिएबल्स एंड to check the consistency and inconsistency of the system of the equations. Okay, so let us see system, consistent system. System of equation is said to be consistent if a system of equation, it means if it is of two variable or of three variable, then that system is said to be consistent if its its solution exists. So if a system is said to be consistent if the solution exists, and inconsistent system means if the solution of the system doesn't exist, then that system is called as the inconsistent system. Okay, suppose a1x plus b1y plus c1z equal to d1, a2x b2y plus c2z equal to d2, a3x plus b3y plus c3z equal to d3. So this is the system of equation which involves the three variables, that involves the three variables. If this system is said to be consistent, then the solution of the system should exist. So solution should be one or more. Okay, that is value of x, y, z should exist. Okay, then this system is said to be inconsistent. If this system is said to be inconsistent, then if its solution doesn't exist, means so there is no value of x, y, z, and they doesn't satisfy the given equation, that is said to be inconsistent system. So here solution exists. Solution exists, that is one or more. Solution should be one or more. And for inconsistent system, solution does not exist. Solution does not exist. And so this is said to be inconsistent system. Okay, so let us come to the solution of system of equation by using the inverse of a matrix. So already you know how to find the inverse of a matrix. Then by using the inverse of a matrix, let us study, let us find the solution of this system of the equation. So finding the solution is nothing but the finding the values of x, y, z. Okay, so see, let us see. So I will write the system of equation. The system of equation is a1x b1y plus c1z is equal to the d1, a2x b2y plus c2z is equal to the d2, a3x b3y plus c3z is equal to d3. So this is the system of three variable equations. Okay, three variables. Here x, y, z are the variables. A, B, C and D are all the constant numbers. Okay, so let us express this system in the form of matrix and then find its solution by using the coefficient inverse matrix. Coefficient of the inverse of matrix. So we can write this system in the form of AX equal to B. We can write this whole system in the form of AX equal to B. So see, A is nothing but a coefficient matrix, means coefficients of X, Y, Z. So what is the coefficient of X? A1, B1, C1, X, Y, Z. Next, A2, B2, C2, A3, x is equal to x, y, z. Small x, small y, small z. So this is the matrix of unknown terms. Matrix of unknowns. We have to find these values by the inverse of a matrix. Then b is equal to the b is equal to the b1, b2, b3. b1, b2, b3. So this is the matrix of constants. Matrix of constant. Matrix of constant. So to find the solution of a system of equation, let us express them in the form of matrix, that is AX equal to B. So where A is the coefficient matrix. Coefficient of X, Y, Z in all the equation. Okay. Then X is, capital X is matrix of unknown. Here 3 unknowns are the X, Y, Z. So this is the matrix of unknown. Then B is equal to B1, B2, B3. So matrix of constant. There is a constant for every equation. So that is written in the form of matrix called as the matrix of constant. Okay. So let us see. There are two cases in this. Case 1, case 2. For which solution exists and doesn't exist. Case 1. So what is the case 1? If A is non-singular. If A is non-singular, it means non-singular means its determinant is not equal to the 0. If A is non-singular, then inverse exists. Then A inverse will exist. If the inverse exists, then the solution also exists. So solution will exist. So let us see. Consider the system. AX is equal to the B. So pre-multiply A inverse on both sides. A inverse AX is equal to A inverse into B. Right? A inverse into A. This is I. X is equal to A inverse into B. X equal to the A inverse into B. So this is the formula to find the matrix of unknown terms. Okay. So we need the value of X, Y, Z from the system of equation. So how to find that one? If the given matrix, that is the coefficient matrix, is not singular, that is the determinant of A is not equal to 0, then inverse will exist. Then you use the formula X equal to A inverse into B. So if we multiply A inverse and the coefficient matrix are constant, we get the matrix of unknown, that is the values of X, Y and Z. Then case 2. In the case 2, what we have to do? If A is singular, then determinant of A is equal to the, then determinant of A is equal to the 0. Determinant of A is equal to 0. In this case, we will consider two sub cases. That is the first one. If A joint of A into B is equal to the 0, and it is if A is a singular, that is determinant is equal to 0. If adjoint of A into B is equal to G, is not equal to 0 matrix, then solution doesn't exist. Then solution does not exist. So in the second case, sub point is first one. If adjoint of A into B is not equal to 0, then solution doesn't exist. Second one, if adjoint of A into B is equal to 0, then solution may exist, may not exist. If the solution exists, it may have infinite number of solution. If it doesn't exist, then it doesn't have any solution. So that is may or may not, may or
formula x equal to a inverse into b. Already we know a inverse formula, that is 1 divided by determinant of a into a adjoint of a. And if a is similar, then determinant of a is equal to 0. That is, in that subcases, first one, adjoint of a into b. If determinant is equal to 0, we will go for the next verification, that is adjoint of a into b. If adjoint of a into b is not equal to 0, then the solution doesn't exist. If adjoint of a into b is equal to 0, then the solution may or may not. Solution may exist, may not exist. If it existed, it may have the infinite number of solution, or it has no solutions. Okay. So let us see some examples. You will get how to solve this system of equation. Okay. This is the theory regarding the system of the solution. The system of the equation of we have to find the solution. Okay. So let us see numerical examples. You will get to know. First check the consistency and inconsistency, then go for the solution of the system of equation. So that is consistent system equations. So examine the consistency of the equation. Examine the consistency of the equation of the system of equation in question number 1 to 6. Question number 1 to 6 is the exercise. Question number 1 is x plus 2y is equal to 5 is equal to 2. 2x plus 3y is equal to 3. Second one. So I take third one is x plus 3y is equal to 5, 2x plus 6y is equal to 8. Okay, one more, fourth one. So x plus y plus z is equal to 1, 2x plus 3y plus 2z is equal to 2, ax plus ay plus 2az is equal to the 4. So we have to check the consistency of these three equations. Okay. So first see, let us write this equation in the form of ax equal to b. That is, let ax is equal to b, where a is the coefficient matrix, x is the matrix of unknown, b is the matrix of constants. So a is coefficient matrix. Nothing is there means its coefficient will be 1. Y coefficient is 2. Here x coefficient is 2. Y coefficient is 3. So x is equal to the matrix of unknown. Here unknowns are x and y. X, y. And b is the matrix of constant. B is equal to the constants are 2, 3. So to check the consistency, first go for its determinant. Let us find the determinant. Determinant of a equal to 1 into 3 is 3. 2 into 2 is 4. 3 minus 4 is minus 1. This is not equal to 0. If determinant is not equal to 0, then the system is consistent and solutions exist. So this implies system is consistent, then and solution exists. Okay, so let us go to this. Write this in the form of ax equal to b. So that is a is equal to the 1, 3, 2, 6, and matrix of unknown x, y, matrix of constants are 5, 8. So determinant of a is equal to the determinant of a equal to 6. 2 into 3 is 6. 6 minus 6 is equal to the 0. So let us see, it is equal to the 0. If we got this equal to 0, then go for the adjoint of a into b. So what is the adjoint of a? I will find here adjoint of a is equal to the adjoint of this interchange is 1 and minus 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 2 minus 3. So interchange the diagonals and change the sign of non-diagonal elements. That is your adjoint of A. Now adjoint of A into B. Adjoint of A into B. So B is 5A. Adjoint of A 6 minus 3 minus 2 1 into B is 5 8. So this is equal to 6 into 5 30, 3 into 8 24, minus 2 into 5 minus 10, 1 into 8 is 8. This is equal to the, this is 6 minus 2. See, this is not equal to the O, means it is not equal to the 0 matrix. If adjoint of A dot B is not equal to 0, adjoint of A dot B is not equal to 0, then solution doesn't exist. It means the system is inconsistent. Therefore, inconsistent system. Okay. So when it is adjoint of A dot B is not equal to 0. Okay. First one, we got determinant of A is not equal to 0. Then we have concluded here only system is consistent. Second one, we got determinant of A is equal to 0. In that case, both of the adjoint of A into B. So we did adjoint of A into B and we got determinant is, sorry, this matrix is not equal to the 0 matrix. Then adjoint of A dot B is not equal to 0 means inconsistent system. The given system is inconsistent. Then come to this. So write this in the form of AX equal to B. Question number 4. So that is A is equal to the coefficient matrix 1, 1, 1, 2, 3, 2, 2, 3, 2, A, A, 2, A. And X is equal to the matrix of unknowns. See here, 3 unknowns are there, X, Y, Z. Write X, Y, Z. And B is matrix of constant 1, 2, 4. 1, 2, 4. Okay. So this is the matrix of constants. Then find the determinant of it. The determinant of A equal to 1 into 3 into 2A is 6A. A into 2 is 2A minus 2A minus 1. 2 into 2 is 4A minus A into 2 is 2A plus 1. 2A minus 3A. 2A minus 3A. So let us see this. This is 6A minus 2A is 4A minus 1. 4A minus 2A is 2A. This is again minus 2A. 2A minus 3A is minus A. 4A minus 3A is A. So A is not equal to 0. It means determinant of A is not equal to 0. Therefore, system is consistent. Therefore, system is consistent. Okay, so this is about the consistent and inconsistent system. So later we solve the remaining questions, that is question number 2, 5 and 6. Okay, now I go to the next concept, that is matrix method. Solution of a system of equation by matrix method. Solve the system of equation. Example number 27. Solve the system of equation. 2x plus 5y is equal to 1. 3x plus 2y is equal to 7. Okay. So let us follow the system of equation. So first write it in the form of Ax equal to b. Let Ax is equal to the b. Write A. A is 2, 5, 3, 2. 2, 5, 3, 2. X is matrix of unknown here only 2. X and y are unknowns. Small x, small y. And B is matrix of constant. That is 1, 7. Okay. So determinant of A is equal to the. Find the determinant. 2 into 2 is 4. 3 into 5 is minus 15. This is equal to minus 7. This is not equal to 0. Okay. Therefore, A is non-singular. If we got determinant is not equal to 0, then A is non-singular and A inverse exists. If A inverse exists, then solution will also exist then. So now go to the find adjoint of A. We need A inverse now. For that, first find the adjoint. Adjoint of A is equal to the adjoint of A is equal to the interchange these two, 2, 2. Change the sign, minus 3, minus 5. Then we know that x is equal to A inverse into x is equal to A inverse into b. So what is A inverse? 1 divided by determinant of A, adjoint of A into b. So we know the formula for A inverse, that only 1 divided by determinant of A, adjoint of A into b. Right? So x equal to 1 divided by determinant of A. 1 divided by determinant is minus 11 into adjoint of A is 2 minus 5 minus 3. 2 minus 5 minus 3 into b. B is 1, 7. 1 into 1, 1, 7. Minus 1 by 11. Multiply this 2. 2 into 1 is 2. 5 into 7 is 35. Minus 3 into 1 is minus 3. 2 into 7 is 14. So this is equal to the minus 1 divided by 11. Minus 1 by 11. This is minus 33. And this is minus 3 plus 14 is 11. Okay. So x means, see here, capital X means xy. xy. This is equal to the take minus 1 by 11 inside. That is minus 33 by 11 means it is 3. Minus 1 by 11 into 11 is minus 1. So we got, therefore, x equal to 3, y equal to the minus 1. So solution of this system of equation is x equal to 3 and y equal to 1. Let us cross verify the result by putting those value of x and y in the given equation. So see, this is our result. Put in this 2x plus 5y is equal to 1. What is the x? 3. 2 into 3 plus 5 into minus 1. This is equal to 6 minus 5 equal to 1. Right? So this is equal to 1. This is verified. Means value of x and y are correct only. Then let us see this one. It should satisfy both equations. 3x and 2y equal to 7. Put the value of x. 3 into 3 plus 2 into minus 1. This is equal to 7. 3 into 3 is 9. Minus 2 equal to 7. 9 minus 2 is 7. 7 is equal to 7. This means the results are correct. Okay. So this is the system of linear equation, system of solution of the equation by matrix method. This method will be called as the matrix method. Okay. So let us first write the given equation in the form of Ax equal to b. A matrix of coefficients, x matrix of unknowns, b matrix of constants. So then find the determinant of A. If it is not equal to 0, then go to the finding the solution. So it is not equal to 0. A is non-singular, mentioned compulsory. A is non-singular and inverse exists. Then to find the A inverse, we need adjoint of A. Adjoint of A is for second order, you have to change the diagonal and change the sign of non-diagonal. We know that x is equal. solution of the system of equation. Okay, so then multiply these two. Okay, you get so capital X means x y x y. These two matrices are equal means their elements, corresponding elements will equal. X is equal to 3, y is equal to the minus 1. So to verify this result, put the value of x and y in the given equation. If they satisfy the given equation, then they are correct. So this is of second variables, two variables. Okay, see next problem. Solve the following system of equation by matrix method. We have to solve the system of equation by matrix method. So they given three equations with three variables x, y, z. So dear students, this by matrix method, this is a very important problem. You will get compulsory one question by matrix method for 5 marks in your NML exam. Okay, so see this system. This is a system already asked in the 2019 March NML examination for 5 marks. So let us see this problem how to solve. Solution. So first write this equation in the form of AX equal to B. Let AX is equal to the B. So what is A? Coefficient matrix 3 minus 2, 3. Next is 2, 1 minus 1. 2, 1 minus 1. Next 4 minus 3, 2. 4 minus 3, 2. Then X is equal to A. Variables x, y, z. Here we have three variables and B is equal to the matrix of constant 8, 1, 4. 8, 1, 4. Okay, so first find the determinant of it. Determinant of A is equal to the 3. 1 into 2 is 2 minus 3 into 1 is plus 3. Minus 2, minus 1, minus 2, because plus, minus, plus. Okay, minus, leave this column and this row. 2 into 2 is 4, minus 4 into minus 1 is minus 4. Then plus 3, plus 3. So leave this column and this row. 2 into minus 3 is minus 6. 4 into 1 is 4. This is minus 4. So 3 minus 1, 2 minus 3 is minus 1, minus 2 minus is plus 2, 4 minus 2 minus is plus 4, it will become 8. Plus 3 minus 6 minus 4 minus 10. Then minus 3 plus 16 minus 30. This is equal to minus 3 minus 30. Minus 33 plus 16. So remaining is 17. So it remains minus 17. This is equal to minus 17. This is not equal to 0. Therefore, A is non-singular. A is non-singular and solution will exist. Solution exists. That is, or you can say A inverse also exists. So solution exists means let us find the adjoint of A first. So adjoint of A. To find the adjoint of A, already you know two methods. By finding the cofactors, that is using the formula Aij. And one more shortcut method, I will follow the shortcut method. 3 minus 2, 3, 2, 1 minus 1, 4 minus 3, 2. This is the matrix A. So repeat the first column, second column. 3, 2, 4 minus 2, 1 minus 3. Next, repeat the first row.
3 minus 2, 3, 3 minus 2. Repeat the second row. -1, 2, 1.
So leave the first row and the first column. Just leave the first row and first column. Then right, multiply. Multiply along the column. Write along the row. Multiply along the column. Write along the row. 1 into 2, 2. -3 into -1 is 3. So this is -1. Next, -3 into 3 is -9. Minus here. -2 into 2 is -4. Okay. So this is -5. +4 -9 is -5. So -5. Next. -2 into -1 is 2. 1 into 3 is 3. This is again -1. Next, come to the second column. -1 into 4 is -4. 2 into 2 is 4. So -4 minus 4 is -8. Okay. 2 into 3 is 6. 6 minus 12. This is -6. 3 into 2 is 6. -1 into 3 is -3. 6 plus 3 is 9. Next, 2 into -3 is -6. 4 into 1 is -4. It is -10. Then 4 into -2 is -8. 3 into -3 is -9. So it will be 1. Next, 3 into 1 is 3. 2 into -2 is -4. 3 plus 4 is 7. So as I did, -1, -5, -1, -8, -6, -9, -10, 1, 7. Okay. So now let us go to the formula. We know that x is equal to A inverse into B. So by matrix method, by solving the matrix method, we will use this formula x equal to A inverse into B. Already we know A inverse is 1 divided by determinant of A into adjoint of A into here is B. What is determinant? So determinant is -17. Adjoint of A is -1, -5, -1, -8, -6, 9, -10, 1, 7. Into B is 8, 1, 4. So -1 by 17. Multiply this -1 into 8 is -8, -5 into 1 is -5, -1 into 4 is -4. -8 into 8 is -64. -6 into 1 is -6. 9 into 4 is, so +36. Okay. -10 into 8 -80. 1 into 1 is +1. 7 into 4 is 28. Okay. -1 by 17, -8, -5, -4 is -17. So let us see here, -64 minus 6 is -17. -17 plus 36 is -34. Okay, -18 plus 29, this is -51. So this is equal to the, take -1 by 17 inside. -17 by -17 is 1. -34 by -17 is 2. -51 by -17 is 3. So this is x. X means x, y, z. So x, y, z is equal to the 1, 2, 3. So this is equal to the x equal to 1, y equal to 2, z equal to equal to 1, y is equal to 2, and z is equal to 3. So this is the solution, x equal to 1, y equal to 2, z equal to 3. So here nothing is new. So just write this equation in the form of a is equal to b. That is the only new thing. And this formula, x equal to a inverse into b. So let us verify this. Verification. So this is called self analysis verification. 3x minus 2y plus 3z equal to a. Put the values. X is 1 minus 2 into y is 2. Z is 3 is equal to a. 3 minus 4 plus 9 is equal to a. See here. 3 plus 9 is 12. Minus 4 equal to 8. So 8 equal to 8 you got. Then the system of equations, what we found solution, y is equal to 1, y equal to z equal to 3 are correct. These are correct only. Similarly, they will hold for second and third equations also. So dear students, this is the matrix method problem, very important for 5 marks. Every year they will be compulsory one question on the matrix method. Okay, thank you. Next class will continue.